Hello everybody, welcome to One Coin Only. It is good to be here today. Good to see everybody. We're back, and we're going to be doing Beta Eat It. And I'm just waiting for all the cool kids to get in here. Yes, this is our Retro Gaming Food Challenge show, guys. For those of you who have not seen Beta Eat It, we do a bunch of mini games via spinning them on the wheel. And if we end up losing more than we win before the time runs out, we have to do a horrible food punishment. My girlfriend this week will be making a mystery dish. And so yeah, mystery dish this week for Beta Eat It. So I'm just waiting for everyone to come in here and then we're going to get started. How you going, Brian? Nick, good to see you. Danny, welcome to the stream. We haven't started a challenge yet. I'm just warming up while everyone comes in. And then we'll spin our first game in about a minute. How you going, Megan? Thank you for following over on Kick as well, by the way. We got Meg over on Kick. Appreciate you, girl. Welcome to Kick. There you go. We're slowly getting some more numbers on Kick. Look out. Jason, thank you for being in here as well. And Andy McIntyre, I'm good. I went to the bakery. I got myself a pork meatball roll, and I had an energy drink. Might even get another coffee soon. I'm still trying to wake up for the day, but that's alright. You know what? Nothing like a couple challenging Beta Eat It challenges to wake you up. I think we'll be fine. How you going, Jeffrey? No, I understand, brother. Thank you for being in here. I hope work's not going too bad. Thank you for hanging out with us today, good sir. I guess I'll just finish this level and then we'll start Beta Eat It officially, huh? There's Jumpy Jumpy Men, huh? How you going, Bernarco? Thank you for coming in. Jumpy Jumpy Fuckity Men. Let's go. And I keep forgetting just how short this level actually is. Megan says, I made it for fish, but I was, yeah, no, I understand. I know. I know he's your favorite, and rightly so. He's a very good streamer. Yes, I'm happy to be your Nancy Kerrigan silver medal, Megan. It's all good. Anyway, we got this. All right, so we're going to do this, and we're going to spin the wheel. And we're going to go here. And we're going to load this up. And once we spin on this game, we'll spin the clock. And Beta Eat It will officially begin for the week. And I'm just waiting for this wheel to load. Man, I tell you what, Google's being a little bit of a sumbish today. Oh, there we go. Now it's working. Oh, okay. So the first spin didn't work. Forgive me, but we'll be all right. We got Bomber Raid. Beat one level. No deaths. So we shut this screen down. Load up Bomber Raid. And all right. Thank you very much for your patience, everyone. So we did the Bomberade challenge last week. Oh gosh. Well, it's always a bit tricky to get off to the first challenge, but then we'll be okay. Lots of wheels, lots of gadgets to pay attention to here in Beta Eat It. Thank you for bearing with me. Jeffrey says, big voodoo energy tonight. I can dig it. This is going out to you, Jeffrey. Thank you very much. And T-Gold boobies as well. There we go. We'll give you both, Jeff.
Playmate of the year!
I want to see her boobies!
Oh. Thank you, Jeff. I appreciate you so much. Here we go. Bomber Raid, guys. All we need to do is beat one level, no deaths here. No, it hasn't. As I said, you know, it's... We're kind of torn, Megan, because we both have wonderful communities on Facebook. Like, as far as community goes, Facebook's amazing, but it's, it is a little bit hard when, I mean, it's like we can't keep up with the changes that are just happening so quick, you know? It's pretty crazy at times, but, you know, we'll work it out, we'll work it out. As I said, if it wasn't for the community, I wouldn't be on this platform anymore, but it just goes to show that community rises above the actual platform itself, so we'll make it work. don't need to talk about that right this second. We're going to keep everything positive today, but yeah. Timmy says it's nice weather today. I'm glad you're having nice weather today, Timmy. Very, very nice. We're having a nice day here too. We went for a walk to get our breakfast today. Now, forgive me, guys. We got to get through this whole level without a death, and this is a bullet hell game, so I've got my work cut out for me here, ladies and gentlemen. We got Shawnee Clark in here. Good to see you. Shane is in here. Where do I get all my cool retro shirts? Oh, you talking about this Hugo Boss I've got on right now? Well, this was like a $5 shirt in a Patong marketplace in Thailand. This is not a legitimate shirt, so the good news is these shirts are only like $5 each. The bad news is you have to go to Thailand to get them. Yeah, I thought as much. I mean, whenever I see you anywhere, Megan, it's either with me, Fish, or Corso, I get you. Well, you know what? You have picked three pretty awesome guys, if I do say so myself, Meg. Yeah, Moe's making the food punishment today, guys. So if I end up losing today, Moe Surprise. Now, if you see her along the course of the stream, she'll tell you exactly what she's making if I lose. But I think just a little bit of a clue. It's a disgusting dessert. A very, very, very disgusting dessert. Just a little bit of a clue as to what I'll be having. When I say dessert, I mean the term dessert very loosely. Jeffrey says, I hope you win. You know what? Last week, technically, I did win. But I didn't win really at all last week. In the sense that I had to do a bunch of freaking punishments anyway. So, I think I ate like 3 boxes of beans last week. And did a bunch of shooies, and so yeah, I may not have had to do the food punishment, but I did other punishments. So I mean, did I really win last week? I don't think so. Hey, God, Chrissy Stringer, good to see you. We'll do our best, always look after you, Megan. I don't take that for granted for a second. Damn, I just lost the challenge, everyone. Bomber, I couldn't have thought, you know, doing a bullet hell game like Bomber Raid from the start, I knew that was probably going to be a little bit too much for me. But you know what, let's spin the wheel again. As everyone's coming in the room and you got a lot more to pay attention to, any bullet hell game's very hard to start with. How you going, Susan? Good to see you. Thank you very much for being in here. Oh, good! We've got Trojan. Now, the good news about this one is this challenge is actually quite long. So, yeah, the really good news about this one is I should be able to find my bearings because this will take about 15 minutes. So I couldn't have thought of anything better to get to start with today. So this is kind of a relief. So yeah, we're going to do Trojan on NES, everybody. And we have to beat the whole game, no deaths. So there it is. Yeah, this is a bit of a relief. And let me just turn the volume down on this one a little bit. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, help me find my feet. Although this is a hard challenge, at least I've got a chance to find my feet now. Brandon, you son of a bitch. Good to see you. Welcome to the stream. Brr-brr-brr. Welcome, man. I hope you're having a great day. Oh, we got this. What else is going on anyway, guys? We all having a good day. What have we been up to? What is new? What is the haps? What are you wearing? All that kind of business. I'm asking some inappropriate questions now, perhaps. What are you wearing? There you go. That's a surefire way to get one coin only cancelled. What you wearing? What are you wearing? And so Colin says Trojan Horse is in the Troy film. Yes, I've seen Troy, Colin. I know what a Trojan Horse is. Hey, we got a raid from Nick Force. There you go, we got Jeffrey McNair, we got Nick Dogg in the house. Don't forget to check out Nick Force and his awesome RPG variety stream party, people. What game is Nick Force playing at the moment? Jonathan says, how's the chicken parmigiana? Good, but that was a good few days ago now. Last night, Moe and I had fried cucumber, egg and pork. So yeah, no, our food was a little bit different last night, bro. We had a healthy dinner last night. How you going, Adam? Good to see you. Oh, he had Super Metroid going. There you go. Well, you go, Nick Force, bringing that big voodoo energy into the freaking community. He's got that big voodoo energy. Hey, so Sean says you bought a blender. Did you get one of those? What is it? One of those bullets or whatever they're called? Nutribullets or whatever it is? No, I didn't, Nick. Forgive me, man, because I literally woke up, had breakfast, and came straight on the stream. So I've had no chance to look at social media since yesterday. I'm glad you got your shirt. So I'm to assume I can go in the VIP group and watch you model it, which is great. I'm having a few issues in the VIP group for some reason. What's happened is Facebook has glitched out. And I'm struggling most days to get any comments on the VIP group. The only reason I haven't been posting the VIP group is because it's broken on my end. I can see what everyone posts, but I can't post anything myself. So I have to try and fix that again. But yes, I'll do that after we're done here. How you going, Damo? Good to see you. Jonah, thank you very much for coming in. Jonah says, I'm here every night. Hey, it has not gone unnoticed, brother. Thank you for being in here. Has not gone unnoticed. You know what? You could start saying inappropriate things. If you're going to say Star Wars, you're just leaving things open, Megan. Like, once you mention Star Wars, some dirty prick is going to be like, oh my god, my lightsaber's getting so long. You know what I mean? Like, that's... You know, maybe don't mention Star Wars. Because, maybe don't mention Star Wars. Hey, go on, Craig. Good to see you. James, thank you so much. We've got Wildy Rug in here. Wildy, we'll be back on TikTok before you know it. The Red Flag Army just doesn't like me too much at the moment. Oh, goodness. Yeah, don't forget your boy One Coin Only is banned on TikTok for gender violence, whatever that is. Wildy Rug gonna be right with you, homie. Gonna do this one for you, brother. No, I haven't done my Mario RPG, bro. I like RPGs, but my community's a bit more casual. As I've mentioned a million times, I don't really stream RPG content too often. And again, people think I hate RPGs, and they don't get what I'm trying to say. It's not that I hate RPGs, I don't. How about the cutting of vegetables for sandwiches? Oh yeah, I mean, well, we just go to the bakery and get our sandwiches, because they're very big and very cheap there. Bakeries in Australia are some of the only things in the country that's still relatively good value for money, to be honest. Yes. Yeah, I have a bit of a big mouth, Mitch. Pass. Oh, there you go. Passes pipe. Please tell me that's not a crack pipe, Megan. You could do better than that. Damn, I'm not having a great start on this level. We need to get through it cleaner, yo. Alright, here we go. We made it. Give me a second, guys. This is probably one of the hardest levels until the final level. There we go. We got the hard bit done, so that's all good. Alright, yeah, that's probably always been for me the hardest level until the final level. So we got this now. How you going, Jeffrey? Good to see you. Craig says you're killing this game. Ah, man, I've been playing this for about 35 years. And so Hitmonkey says the problem with RPG streams is it ends up being a story element, so it's difficult to interact with the chat. Dude, even when I try to play a horror game or something more story-based, Look, you know, and I'm not saying this is a rib, because we all have our quirks, and a lot of us have like, different disabilities or disorders, but I'll try to play a story-based game, and all the ADHD people are in here, can't even, like, shut up for 5 fucking minutes while I'm trying to watch a cutscene. And it's just like, Jesus, man. So I just can't play story-based games here. No one will take 2 minutes, to watch a freaking cutscene. It's always like the blah, 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 blah. It's like, dude, read the room. There's like a fucking cutscene on, but it's okay. I understand that I've got to play to the community strengths, and like I said, story-based games is not part of it. So it's all good. It's all good. There's plenty of other amazing games that we can play on One Coin Only. Colin says, finish the story. Yes. Nothing wrong with civility. I know, it's all good. As I said, look, you know, I just play to the community strengths, and we got a good thing going, so it's all good. Your monkey says, any luck with Bayonetta? See, the problem with Bayonetta is that I'm not gonna lie to you, Hitmonkey, and thank you for gifting me that. I still never forget, by the way. A few years ago, a game like Bayonetta or Dante's Inferno would be a perfectly good stream choice. But I feel like social media audiences have evolved out of open world games a little bit because of the pacing. And like I said, unless there's something happening in these games straight away, it's very hard to hold the interest of people. And so, you know, Bayonetta, while it's very, very action-packed, there's a lot of elements where you're walking around or figuring out minor puzzles or mazes or whatever. And those elements, and even in games like Devil May Cry and stuff, those slower parts of the game are what scare people away. And it's just like, man, you always have to have something happening. Always has to be. And that's why Beta Eden is so popular. Because I'm either spinning the wheel or playing the game or some drama is happening. And, the more that's happening on your stream, the better your stream is gonna go. So, it's, just is what it is, man. Oh, yes. Yes, we don't talk about Dante's Inferno, because then I have to remind the stream over what a big voodoo head Nick was a few years ago. Isn't that right, Nick? I'll never forget the way you treated me in 2020 just because I got stuck on a fucking puzzle. There you go. I'm probably going to charge you still a cunny tax every week still for that very stream, Nick. Anyway, we got this. All right, we're up to the final level, everybody. We got Danny in here, and we got Amanda. Lovely to see you guys. Thank you for hanging out. And Foosh, this is for you, man. Thank you for the 100 stars. Troy, welcome to the stream. Now, this is the last level. This one's going to take a bit more concentration. How you going, James? Good to see you. Colin says he likes my headband and the t-shirt. There you go. Well, that's a big relief. People usually ask me to take off more clothing. You want me to put on more clothing. That's a big relief. Thank you for not treating me like you're like an object. Have I ever had the Mr. Sim sour candy? No, I haven't had that brand before. I have not. One day. Here we go. Last level, everybody. I'm ignoring all the how's the weather questions right now. The stupid how's the weather questions, they're being ignored for one level. Hey, Ricky, how's the weather? It's gonna be dark soon when I shove your head up your ass. Here we go. How's the weather? We will not be fielding any how's the weather questions through the course of this level. Here we go, we got this. My gosh, this man, look at this guy. He's got some big missile energy today. Oh, we did it. Thank goodness. Yeah, well, I'm hoping we can beat this with one life today. It's going to be very close. This is a game called Trojan Legend. This is a game called Trojan. How you going, Jeff? Good to see you. Thank you very much for being in here. There it is. So we just got the final boss left. How's the pizza? Well, if there's something Brisbane knows a few things about, it's great pizza joints here. Moe and I were actually going to do some social media content and try and find Brisbane's best pizza. But Moe and I are on a diet at the moment, so it's probably not a good idea. But one day we want to travel around and find Brisbane's best pizza. There you go, guys. We just ended up beating the Trojan Challenge. There you go. So that takes us to one win and one loss. And that didn't take us too long to get through that game. That was actually really quick, wasn't it? We're going to spin the Wheel of Wonder again. And what do we got now? We have reset wins and losses. There you go. Resetting wins and losses, ironically enough, is very meaningless because we're on one apiece now. So really, that's about as pointless as tits on a bull today. But that's okay. That's zero wins and zero losses. Back to the beginning. And all right, well, we'll spin this wheel again, won't we? Let's go. There you go, Marco. We got Marco. Good to see you, man. Alan, thank you very much. The Walkers are in here. Timothy says Mick and Pip. Love and Uncle Ricky. Thank you very much for coming in. We got Ninja Gaiden. We're going to beat two levels, two lives. So we're going to do that in a second. Before we do that, this is for Mick and Pip. I see where you're going with this, Hitmonkey. I guess even with certain levels of protection, there's never a sure thing, right? So yeah, once again, a big shout out to the Walker family. We got Ninja Gaiden here, and all right, let's see how we go with this bad boy. We got this. Tits on a bull, yes. We have some great expressions here in Australia, my friend. Trevor, you have a good one. Thank you for coming in. We're just going to do two levels, two lives today. I actually increased it to two lives. Before it was no deaths, but we actually get two lives. Anyway, I'll take it. Any challenge that's easier. Hey, go, Tony. Good to see you. Yeah, it used to be one life. I don't know why I moved it to two lives. Maybe that was a typo, but hey, it is what it is. I get two lives today. Yeah, for some reason I made this challenge a little bit easier. I was already 50-50 on it. I don't know, there must be a reason. Oh well, we can reevaluate that at the end of the week. Yeah, I can imagine that would probably be a Texas expression. Yes, well, we're gonna see how we go. A lot of great classics on. I think that part of the reason Beat or Eat It works so well, it's not even the fast pacing of the show, it's just all the freaking classics that you play in one place on one show. So many classics every week. The cream of the crop of retro games is on this wheel. There we go. Hey, we didn't even lose any health there. How about that? Just a reminder, I'm not back on TikTok until the 24th, guys. I've had some professional issues on TikTok. So, I've removed Raiden off the wheel. I really sucked at Raiden. I've never ever beaten that challenge or even gotten close once. So Raiden's off the wheel. That was a bad choice of game. I'm not saying Raiden's a bad choice of game, I'm saying it's a bad choice of game for Beat or Eat It. You know what option I'm going to give you guys next season? If you spend a certain star amount, I immediately have to cancel the game and play a game that's on the wheel of your choosing. So that could be pretty vital at, like, say, the end of a episode of Beat or Eat It or something. So that's what I'll do for next season. There's always new wild cards and fun little quirks that I can add. Keep it going. Yeah, but no, Raiden's off the wheel. That game just didn't work out at all. Can't believe I'm already halfway through my week here. It's currently Wednesday, man. The weeks just seem to go quicker and quicker and quicker. Moe's already been here for 5 weeks, guys. 5 weeks today. That's like half her visit. It's freaking crazy. Yeah. Time has been going very, very quickly. What do I think of the Darius twins? I like Darius, Darius X? I haven't played the Darius twins games, though. You're here for the games and the Ricky rants. Well, as long as you're here for something. What's some of the newest games on the wheel? Oh, don't make me remember off the top of my head, Hitmonkey, but one thing I can tell you is I took off about 12 stale games from last season and then added about another 12. So I don't remember off the top of my head exactly what they are, bro. And please don't make me try and concentrate while doing these challenges either, bro. But there are 12 new games on the wheel this season. And most of my, you know, as I said, I just got rid of the 12 ones that were probably the most stale or not good for the show, and then I just replaced them with better ones. Yeah. No, I'm gonna be quite real with you. I hate it when I've got one more life that I'm allowed to use. I hate it when people ask me questions during Beta Edit that I have to really fucking think about, because it just fucks me up for this show. And you're gonna get a cunny tax if you do it. Anyway. Oh, dude. Alright, well, there you go. I just lost the Ninja Gaiden challenge. Well, that takes us to 0-1. Very close to getting a cunny tax, Hitmonkey. We're gonna spin the wheel. And Sean says, no, I didn't take cool spot off the... Fuck's sake. No, I did not! What do we got now? Operation Wolf. Beat 2 levels, 1 credit. There we go. We're going to do Operation Wolf now, party people. And, alright, here we go. We got to do 2 levels, 1 credit, everybody. Let me just check this. There we go. Yeah, I have more time. Yes. Oh, Hitmonkey paid his cunny tax. Well, thank you, Hitmonkey. There you go. Thank you for making up for being naughty. Hitmonkey with a big $1 super chat. Your transgressions, Hitmonkey, have now been forgiven.
Operation initiated.
Oh, goodness. All right, let's go. See how we do on this bad boy today. The first level's obviously very easy. I feel like the second level, and this is one of the hardest levels in the game. Usually, generally speaking, if I can get past the second level in Operation Wolf, I can sometimes do a one-credit play of this game. So let's see how we go today. Yes, the Operation Wolf challenge today. How you going, Justin Evans? Thank you for hanging out. Welcome to the stream. You like this one than Operation Thunderbolt? I think technically Operation Thunderbolt was a better game, but I think the thing with Operation Thunderbolt was it was a case of been there and done that. And so, you know, this was obviously the one that started it all. People are going to always remember Operation Wolf more fondly. Jordan says, here's to the 4-tier awards. Thank you, Jordan. Technically, we have to get to 500k to complete tier 3, but we have like a half a month to do it. So I thought, look, I may as well just put tier 4 up there because the chances of not completing tier 3 are practically zero. So yeah, I just skipped ahead. Jordan, this is going out to you. Thank you, brother. No, it's okay, Hitmonkey. I still can't remember what new games. My brain's just not working right now, man. I'm actually concerned. I added 12 new games to the wheel this month, and I can't remember which ones I removed or which ones I added. My memory's just not working, so I don't know what else to tell you. The brain's just not working today. You'll be obvious when a new game comes up anyway. Hey, go on, Ori. Thank you for coming in. Welcome to the stream. We might have to start using our rocket soon. Hopefully they'll drop a health item here. Gotta be careful we don't shoot these little kids. Sometimes if we're lucky, there's a health item on the ground, but it doesn't happen every level. I think it's at random. Yeah, sometimes there'll randomly be a health item on the ground, but I don't know what you have to do to unlock it. I hope we pass. We've had a good track record on Operation Wolf lately. Oh, we're already up to it. Alright, well, we're just gonna shoot this egghead. I just ended up shooting her. So we passed, but I ended up shooting the innocent woman. I'm a fucking monster. I'm an absolute monster. I mean, I know I technically passed, and that's a win, but did I truly win when I conduct such evil? I mean, that is some fucking evil. I am a rotten human being. Anyway, let's spin the wheel. How you going, T? Good to see you, my brother. Thank you for coming in. Yeah, I'm pretty horrible. And Street Fighter the movie. We're going to beat 4 opponents, 1 credit. How often do you need to replace your equipment for streaming? Well, it's not one size fits all, bro. When things are not running optimally, and if you can afford it, then that's when you start replacing your equipment. You guys are asking me questions that don't have a single straight answer. Anyway, do Street Fighter the movie here. 4 opponents, 1 credit, everybody. We'll play as Ken today. Round 1. How you going, Andrew Valentine? Thank you for being in here. Damn, Ming-Na Wen's having a way with me. Damn it. Oh my gosh. Hurricane. Oh, fuck. We got it.
Win. Round 2. Fight.
Probably would have preferred to use Ryu, to be honest, but that's okay. I'll use Ryu next time. How you going, Brendan? Good to see you. Well, I mean, it's not the same answer for everybody. Some people's equipment might break quicker than others. Some people might do a different type of game or have different needs. Anyway, it's okay, Colin. Ken. And so Jane says, Rick, thoughts on Raw and the Crybabies promo? I tell you what, so Moe's only just started watching the wrestling with me, and she's enjoying the wrestling every week now, God bless her, she's taken a genuine interest. But I think even she's starting to get sick of the whole I hit you finish the story crap. Like, you'll see Moe sitting on the couch, and even she's mocking Cody Rhodes right now. So, no, Raw was okay, but it's just I am sick of the whole Cody Rhodes shit. I don't dislike Cody, but I saw a very, very interesting panel on the Vince Russo channel where Vince Russo and Stevie Richards were talking, and Stevie Richards is saying, look, you know what, everything right now is, I'm paraphrasing a little bit, but Stevie Richards was saying that everything is getting so cringe now that if Cody Rhodes finishes the story, he has to instantly turn heel. And I'm kind of agreeing with that, to be honest, because Cody Rhodes shit's starting to get very cringe. I know almost immediately after he wins the belt, the fans will probably start turning against him. Yes. There you go, we got Brendan McKenzie. Sorry, man. Hope you're having a wonderful day. We got Azeem in here. Good to see you, Azeem. Thank you for coming by. Welcome to the stream. And we got Johnny Who Knows in here as well. We're still figuring out what it is that Johnny knows, by the way. And Kevin says, you think Vince Russo is cringe? I stick up for Vince Russo. I'm not going to say that he's always right and gets everything perfect. But I feel like Vince Russo most of the time gets a lot of unfair hate. And, you know, I think people need to stick up for him sometimes. You know, because they're very outspoken people as well. Like, and Vince is also outspoken. You've got people like Eric Bischoff and Jim Cornette that people seem to bandwagon, who are not the nicest of people either. I don't get it myself. But, I think people like to pick on Vince Russo because it kind of feels like low-hanging fruit to me. Yeah, pretty much Azeem. This is Street Fighter the movie. Me versus me mirror matches are funny. They can be a bit confusing, can't they? Hey, go on, Maddie. Good to see you. Thank you for being in here today, bud. I hope you're great. Yeah, exactly. You don't have to always agree with someone to respect them and to validate them. You thought Bischoff was dead? He was 70 in the WCW days. No, he was only in his mid-40s in the WCW days. Eric Bischoff was only in his 40s. He was pretty young. He's looking pretty old now. He's around about 70 now. 70 odd. We just have to win this fight and then we get another win on the board. How's everything going, Matty? You looking after yourself? Oh, okay. Oh, that's a bit cheeky, isn't it? Oh, we did it. Okay, that is four opponents that we've just beaten everybody, so we're going to put another win on. Does that take us back to even again? Oh no, we're actually one in the lead. Well, hell yeah, that worked out, didn't it, homies? Let's go back to the Wheel of Wonder and spin again, party people. Big thank you once again for being here on Facebook and YouTube. If you're enjoying the stream, hit the thumbs up button today. We got Space Harrier. Beat four levels with two lives. So we're sticking with the arcade theme right now. Sticking with the arcade theme. Four levels, two lives. Yeah, Danny, it's all working out, homie. And now just moving this over here. There we go.
Welcome to the fantasy zone. Get ready.
I think the game was on the Saturn. I think D-Wayne even has a copy too. Don't hold me to this, but I think D-Wayne might actually have an actual copy of the game. Which shouldn't surprise you, because it's very Mortal Kombat-y in style. How you going, Luke? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Yes. Nah, nah, drive a new car. Nah, nah, I like the music. Don't forget, every song I make's usually singing about some kind of car. No, Timothy, we're playing the arcade version today. The Master System version doesn't look anywhere near this nice. But it is still fun to play. RJ says he'll be back in an hour. No problem. Easy. Easy. That, yes, there you go. Colin's giving me a little bit of general knowledge. Well, I appreciate that. I'm not doing a very good job here. Almost got him. There it is. Hey, here we go, everyone. We need to send a big congratulations to Damo. Man, that's what I'm talking about. Damo bringing the big voodoo energy to the workforce, has himself a job. Hey, brother, a big congratulations. When do you start, homie? I knew something was going to come up, bro. I knew something was going to come up. He's got that big voodoo energy. Man, congratulations. Hell yeah. Load Runner. You think Load Runner's similar to this game? I don't think Load Runner's anything like this game. And I absolutely hate Load Runner too. Any platforming game that has no jump button. I mean, I don't want to play a platforming game if I have no legs like Lieutenant Dan. So, yes, it's just, it's not happening. Damn it, I've only got one life left.
Get ready. You're doing great.
Yes. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. This one's a bit in the tricky side, everybody. How you going, Eric? Nice to see you. Thank you for coming in. This is one of my favorite games to play, so obviously you don't want to fail my favorite game today. That would really suck. Almost out of here. Almost out of here. Alright, cool. Hey, have I ever streamed Alien Syndrome? I have put Alien Syndrome on before as a bonus game. Actually, you know what? Thank you for reminding me, because Alien Syndrome would actually make a really, really good Beat or Eat It challenge, actually. So, Alien Syndrome would actually work very well on the Beat or Eat It wheel. It's not that hard to do. Maybe one full level of Alien Syndrome and boss in one life. That would be a good challenge. Or maybe one credit three, either one credit and three levels or one level, one life. But Alien Syndrome's a good game. That's Nigel's favorite game, actually. Favorite retro arcade game, anyway. Out of every video game I've played, Alien Syndrome probably actually feels the most like the Aliens movies.
You're doing great.
There we go, we got that. We just did the Space Harrier Challenge, everyone. So that takes us to 3 wins and 1 loss. So we're finally breaking away a little bit. It's all good in the hood here. Let's spin the Wheel of Wonder again and see what we got, homies. Wouldn't most beat-em-ups work for Beat or Eat It? Depends, actually. But I do have a couple. No, we're going to spin again. I do have a couple on the wheel, but it depends. Mike says, is this better than Space Harry 3D? Yes, although I do like Space Harry 3D. Oh, shit. All right, we've got Bayou Billy. Beat one level, one credit. I mean, this challenge is next to impossible. The main reason I have this challenge as a thing is mainly for comedy purposes. So, yeah, the only real reason I have this challenge as a thing is more for comedy purposes. So, alright, Bayou Billy. Let's see how we go. Yeah, wow. Comedy purposes only, everybody. Let me have a quick drink of water. Yes, and this is an easier mod of the game, and I still can't beat a level. So this is mainly for comedy purposes. Yeah. I know everyone's like, Rick, play Bayou Billy, Rick, play Ubility. So I only put this on the wheel to appease the trolls. Yes. There you go, Bayou Billy, everyone. It's about a guy called Billy, he's on the Bayou. Oh my gosh, this is torture. I'm probably going to regret. Look, I've almost lost half my health already. I've almost lost half my health already. Hopefully this red sumbish will drop either a health or a weapon. No, nothing this time. The only good thing about this game is actually the music. But let's be honest, the music in this game is dope. I'm almost dead already. Hopefully we get the gun or the weapon in a sec. The pole or whatever. Fuck! Hey, we just got a full health, so there's that. Oh my gosh. There it is. Hey, you on David Craig? Good to see you, Craig David. Thank you for being in here. Oh my gosh, die you fuck. Yeah, it's a Konami game. The Adventures of Bayou Billy. Let's go. We got it. It'd be one level, one credit, everyone. Yeah, Timmy, we know what Timmy wants. I haven't had to do a shooey yet today, but probably just a matter of time, brother. Probably just a matter of time. Out of here we go. We don't need to hang around for the crocodiles today. Oh, look at this rock fucker. Can we pick up the rock and throw it at people? No, I can't pick up the rock. I can pick up this though. Alright, cool. Hey, I'm Patrick Kopecki. Thank you for being in here. Welcome to the stream. Man, look at all the sprite flicker and everything as well, if the game wasn't hard enough. Are you happy that I put this one on the wheel? I'm not even sure if people are happy that I put this game on the wheel. Hey, go on, Neo Blitz. Thank you for coming in. And I know this game's reputation precedes it, so I don't know how happy you are that it's on the wheel. You know, if it would be one thing as well if you died, you instantly respawn. But you don't. You have to go back to a checkpoint, and that's pretty freaking brutal, man. That is brutal. And look what happened! That weapon just glitched out. So now I don't even have the weapon. That's crazy. It glitched out because of the sprite flicker. So it despawned. Well, there we go. We got the weapon again. Even with the pipe, I can't knock fools out. Anyway. Yeah, the pipe doesn't even make the game any fucking easier, apart from a little bit of extra reach. Crazy, man. There you go, there's one. I think when it comes to Konami games, this is one of the more tedious ones. Although, yeah, you're right, they are known for very hard games. Oh, there's that. Oh, dude, what the fuck? I have a knife. Alright, we got him. James says you don't like paying the one coin. Well, don't be a cunny then. It's quite simple, bro. Don't want to pay the one coin only tax? Don't be a cunny. Not rocket science. Oh, gosh. There is a meat there that we can get. Dude, man, I'm trying to get past here, guys. Look at these freaking alligators. Now, how long is it gonna take to kill these sumbitches? Oh, baby, I'd love another coffee, thank you. Yeah, can you tell I'm not waking up too well today? too, babe. Yeah. Thank you. Moe's giving me some refreshment, everybody. Dude, what the hell? Okay, we got one. And I got my health back there, so there's that. How you going, Shawnee LeBeau? Thank you for being in here. I did it. I can't believe it, guys. I did it. And now we got some James Bond shit happening over here. Oh my god, this is crazy. Oh my... oh boy. You know what, I'm happy that we only have to do this challenge once a... Fuck! Hey Gonrello, good to see you, thank you for being in here. Alright, let's do it again. I'm gonna go after the one with the gun first. No, they've all got guns. I don't know what I just picked up. Oh my gosh. I think this is my last life, everybody. I wonder if I could pick up a gun. Yeah, babe, it's freaking rough. It's very rough. Oh, there's a gun over here. Can we get... There we go. We got the gun. Okay, that didn't work out for us. Well, we just lost the Bayou Billy challenge, guys. I gave that a great effort. And look, I tell you what, we'll try it again next time. But as it stands, we just lost the Bayou Billy challenge today, everyone. So we're going to pull up the Wheel of Wonder again. And just give me a second here. Once again, I just want to thank everyone so much for coming in. We hope you're having a great day. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up on Facebook and YouTube if you like Beat or Eat It and you want to support today. So, we are going back, to this screen here. There we go. We're going to spin the... Oh, the wheel. I pricked the wrong one. Here we go. Got it. And Larry says, it's a shame because the idea of the game is really, really good, but it's flawed. All right, we got Rast in the arcade game. We're going to beat one dungeon, one whole level, that is, with four lives. So here we go. We've got the Rastin challenge now. I like playing Rastin. I've been doing freaking god horrible on this challenge lately. Hopefully today is the day we can turn it around. Peyron, I see that you're here. I can smell your cunniness from anywhere. How you doing, Peyron? Good to see you. Maddie, I appreciate that, bro. Thank you very much. I'm not a guy that goes out and buys designer clothes, though. Don't forget, I spend a lot of time in Phuket, Thailand, and I pick up all these shirts from a shed for $5. So, they're comfortable and they look nice, and therefore I spend my $5 and I get one. Hey, Timothy says, amazing stream as usual. Hey, Timothy, I appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you very much once again to the Walker family. We're going to do this one for you guys this time. Thank you. Donnie, you have a good one. Sorry, I didn't mean to miss... Man, I'm missing a lot of comments today. I just remind you guys to be patient with me on Beta Eat It. I love interacting with you all. If I do miss a comment or two, don't forget, the purpose of me is to be very competitive on this show so I don't have to do a food challenge. So, don't be offended if I miss anything. It's always good to have a couple nice butter-ups if you need something that's a bit more smart casual. James, nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. It's not like it's your whole wardrobe. So Jonah, have a good sleep. It's good to see you in here as well. One, thank you for being in here. All right, that's one death, everybody. That's one death already. Yeah, I like those. I like very bold patterns on shirts sometimes. Now, I'm not talking Ed Hardy shirts, but one thing I liked about Ed Hardy shirts back in the day was how bold they were. I understand that they're very tacky looking back on it, but I mean, sometimes, you know... Like, the shirts Rocky wears on SmackDown, they're pretty bold, you know what I mean? Like, the room pays attention when he walks to the ring. Thank you, beautiful. Sorry, babe. My concentration's not what it normally is. Moe just came in with a coffee. Isn't she a sport? Oh, gosh. How you going, Chrissy Ogle? Good to see you today. Welcome to the stream, brother. Thank you, man. I'm really enjoying making those 3-minute videos on YouTube right now. I get great joy out of them. Larry says he's digging the graphics and the music. I've only got 2 lives left to do this challenge. Let's make it work, everybody. If we're lucky, we'll get a goat head. When you get a goat head, that means you get full health back. Out of here. Come on, we can do this. A goat head would be nice right about now. No, I meant Ed Hardy. Sorry. Did I say Ed Harry? I meant Ed Hardy. Sorry. Ed Harry is a men's shop that went broke. Correct. I used to shop from there too. Hey, go on, Nick Gamer. Welcome to the YouTube. Thank you for coming in. We got one more life to do this challenge. If we die here. Come on, please drop a goat. Let me get my health back. Oh my gosh, your boy One Coin Only is in a little bit of strife here, everybody. Fucking hell, this is my last life, everyone. So, Kuda's trying to predict WrestleMania. You're going to predict Bayley's going to win and new men's tag champs. I think there's going to be new men's tag champs too. I'm wondering if it's going to be the Miz and R-Truth. Kind of for that WrestleMania feel-good moment. I don't know. How cool would it be, you know, if the Awesome Truth won the tag belts, they'd hold them for about 5 minutes. It'd still be fun though. Who? You have no idea how EB Games is still around. EB Games makes all their money from secondhand games. They don't make anything from new stuff. So in order for EB Games to make money, they need to sell a lot of insurance protection and also sell secondhand games. That's how they make their money, through insurance and secondhand games. Think DIY. I'm not a fan of DIY, hey, and then not because they're not great wrestlers, because they're great wrestlers and they're fun to watch. I think more just from a character perspective. They just don't really do it for me. Although they wrestled a fantastic match this week, but it's, yeah. Bernarco says, Ricky, is April Fool's a thing in Australia? Yes, it is. Yes. I mean, we don't take it ultra seriously, but yeah, it's a thing. Justin, just keep... What percentage do I give? I think 0%. I don't think it's gonna happen, honestly. I think it's very tabloid. I think 0%. Hey, got an Amiga, we got Amiga Cammy in here. You spend a lot of money on Star Wars toys. Fuck! Oh, there you go, there's another challenge we've lost. We need to get back in the game. Alright, let's spin the wheel again, everybody. We're on a bit of a losing streak right now. Hope you're doing great, Master Rogue Assassin. I appreciate you coming in, legend. Alright, we got Dark Castle and Sega Genesis. We gotta beat the game on one credit. This game is actually not hard for me until the very last level. So, I mean, let's see how we go on Dark Castle today, everybody. James says, this sounds like a Sega Mega Drive game. You would be correct, sir. You'd be very correct. Hey, go on, Johnny Lupo. Welcome to the stream. Andrew says, what is on the menu if you lose, Rick? If I lose today, Moe is making a mystery dessert for me. She can come in here in a second and tell you exactly what I'm making. She's just in the living room right now. I think Moe is giving me ice cream with a special homemade fish sauce. So instead of chocolate topping or strawberry topping or caramel topping, Moe's making a very special ice cream with fish sauce, as far as I know. So it's gonna be freaking disgusting. It's gonna smell like Heron's underwear. And yeah. Right, let's go. Yeah, good on you. Well, I'm glad you're playing the games that you love. It's important to do that every day. Maybe add fish. Well, no, that defeats the purpose. I'm supposed to do what's disgusting for B to eat it, James. And so you want everyone to do your best gargoyle call. All right. Ah! Ah! There you go. Do I pass? Ah! There you go. Ah! Oh, there we go. Chris wants me to add two wins because he's an awesome sumbitch. Isn't that right, Chris? Chris, when I heard that whenever someone adds two wins onto the beat or eat it wheel, they have some massive voodoo energy. And I appreciate that very, very much, bud. We're just going to wait for the lightning to hit our shield and then we're out of here. Give me 1 second, Chris. All right, there it is. So we're gonna do this one in a second. We're gonna do the ultimate celebration. That is a big donation, bro. Thank you, Chris, so much. Jeff enjoys this one. There you go. Brother, thank you very much. Hell yeah. That's putting us... Did I add the two wins? I don't even think I added the two wins yet. I'll do that as soon as I get to the next section, which is just over here. Yeah, we'll add those two wins now. I'll pause here. Just before I forget, there we go. So we're gonna that's gonna take us to 5 and 3. You're making Jeff and Josh's job a little bit harder for them today, and I appreciate that. Oh gosh. Oh, here she is. How you going, baby? Chris very kindly just added two wins. Yes, yeah, so I was on 3 wins and 3 losses, and Chris just made my life a little bit easier for me. Yes. You're making her life easier for her. She'd probably prefer not to cook today. So tell everyone in the chat, babe. You can squeeze in. Tell everyone in the chat, babe, what the challenge is today. Everyone wants to know what the punishment is, babe. So she's gonna mix fermented fish and chili together. And so not only is it gonna be stinky fish, but it's gonna be spicy as well. And she's gonna put it on top of ice cream. There you go, that's what we got. And so yes. And this game reminds you of another world. Yeah, you know what? Maybe a little bit. I can see where you would get that from. Maybe a little bit, Marco. Maybe a little bit. Your G Fuel got... Yeah. Or the gargoyle. Ah! That's the other one. Or my pig. Oh, gosh. There you go. Mick has just sent you 100 stars, babe.
Thank you, Mick.
Oh, yeah, of course. Thank you, Mick. Yes. See, I have to eat disgusting things for my stars. You just have to look pretty. It's not fair. it's a bit unfair, isn't it? Yes.
I'm still smelling of you. Get more.
Yeah. Oh, gosh. Trying to open this up. There we go. Trying to find the pathway here. There we go. Okay. I'll try this. I can't open the pathway up. I'm trying to work out what it is. Give me a sec, guys. Just gonna shoot this thing one more time. Okay, maybe backwards. Yeah, I haven't figured out the puzzle yet. Which one haven't I... Oh, there it is. The most basic one. All right, we got it. So we're going to do a screen for Timmy, by the way. Or for Mickey, I should say. This is for you. Keeping Chris, is everything okay? I haven't seen you in the better part of a week. How you going, Mr. Lindley? Chris has finally come back in. Yes, I haven't seen you in nearly a week. Everything all good, hey man? I understand life happens and you're busy. Just hope everything's okay. Yeah. How's everything going, Chris?
Well, yeah.
Now, don't forget, if we end up getting thrown in the dungeon, it's an instant disqualification. Just a heads up on that. All right, so we're waiting for the gargoyles here in a sec. There we go, we got him. They're the things you have to look out for the most in this run. Oh, okay, perfect. That's all right. That's a good reason then. That's all good. Just as long as... Oh, dude, fuck off. Babe, I stuffed up. I'll have to do this again now. Okay. We have one whole credit here, so it's okay. You think the Philips CD-i version of this is more painful? I actually grew up with this on the Mega Drive, but the first console ever had this on was the Apple Mac. And, I mean, if you can learn how to play this with a keyboard and mouse, you can play this on anything. Where's this gargoyle at? Chris says, happy to have you back, you legend. Just waiting for the gargoyle. It's a gargoyle? Oh, that's a rat, yes. I'm just going to get out of this room and then I'm going to give Chris a great big thank you. I'm just going to keep my mojo going at the second. Thanks again, Chris, homie. One more gargoyle's going to appear and then we can get out of here. Deep breath. Oh, gosh. Coffee's working a little bit. I've only had a couple sips. Because I had so much going on here, babe. Peter, he did a crazy show. Oh, dude, I thought I shot him. I lost. Motherfucker. That was just never going to be an easy one today. Chris, this is for you. Thank you, bro.
What is this, and how can I make the rest of my life about it?
Yeah, that didn't work out too well, did it? All right. Chris, I know Mr. Ogle added a couple wins, and I hope they don't end up being meaningless for him, because, I just lost. And I can hardly talk today, baby. Me. What do we got? We got reset wins and losses. Oh, that's brutal. After Chris added the extra wins as well. Look at this. I'm back to 0-0.
In this one,
yeah, I spun on reset wins and losses for the second time today. That's a bit rough, isn't it? What do we got? All right, let's have a look. All right, we got Aladdin. Beat two levels on hard mode and we can't die once. This is actually the first time we've put Aladdin on the wheel there, actually. So we got Aladdin, we got to beat two levels on hard mode, no deaths. Chris says the wheel gives zero fucks. It really does. Difficult. Let's see how hard this is. It's been a hot minute since I played this on hard mode, so, yeah, Aladdin is on the wheel. I think that surprises no one that Aladdin was eventually going to go on the wheel. Did you ever see the cartoon? Yeah, I love it.
No, I just want to ask you.
Yeah.
You
watch the movie? My favorite Disney cartoon of all time is Aladdin. I can show you the world. Yes. Sega's Aladdin is the best, I think. The Super Nintendo one's no slouch, but I do think the Sega one's better. So all we have to do is two stages, no death. Take about maybe 5 minutes. Oh, gosh. So far, so as I said, this is like a harder mode. I don't notice any differences yet. And no worries, Nick says goodbye. All right, Nick, have a great day. Goodbye, Nick. Did I like the movie version? Yeah, I thought the Will Smith. Did you see the Will Smith Aladdin, babe? I thought it was good. It's good. I do think they could have made Jafar a little bit more interesting as a villain. But I like what Will Smith did with it. I don't think he was trying to be Robin Williams. I think he was just doing his own thing with it. So, no, I thought it was great, to be honest. The problem with the live-action Aladdin is no one's going to give it a chance because they're just going to compare it to Robin Williams, and I think that's what kind of happened with the movie. Exactly. That's my point. Let me guess. There's only one genie and it's Robin Williams. Is that right, Kevin? Exactly. I think I just said, Blake, literally said 2 seconds ago, I think the Sega version's the best, but the Super Nintendo one's okay too. Yes, and I don't think Will Smith was trying to compete with Robin Williams. He was doing his own thing with it. Yeah, my Monterey thinks the Sega one's better. I just think it's, I feel like this version does a great job of following the movie. Oh, there you go, that's one level done. One more level on no deaths and yeah, we got a win. This is turning out to be an easy challenge. Well, I will back up your argument. I mean, I did mention in that they could have probably done more with Jafar. So, yeah, I think the whole Jafar thing was probably lacking. So, okay, you know what? You do have a point on that one, but overall, I still thought it was a good film. Yeah, so what I like about, I mean, you throw apples in this one too, but at least Aladdin in this one has a sword. On the Super Nintendo version of Aladdin, all he did was throw apples. And what kind of bitch male only throws apples? Having a sword makes you alpha, babe. We're alpha because we have a sword. Yeah. How you going, Alan? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Yeah, she's like, Aladdin's eating healthy when he picks up all those apples. Hey, if you eat 500 apples a day, you're still gonna get fat. It's like, there's an expression, an apple a day keeps a doctor away unless you eat 500 of them. Oh crap, I keep going the wrong way. I don't know why I'm struggling here at the moment. Maybe I just have to jump up this way. There we go. You think the sound effects on Sega Genesis are so good in general? I feel like Sega always has that distinct sort of like guitar string, dirty distortion sound in their games, which people either love or hate. And then I think the Super Nintendo always has a distinct sort of like kick drum and a synth that's pretty common in all their games as well. Don't forget, I have to do 2 levels no deaths and I'm almost dead on this one already, so I gotta be a little bit more careful, guys. Okay, we can't go that way, that's okay. You can't throw apples at the snakes, apparently. No, you have a good one too, One. Thank you for coming in. Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow, hopefully, brother. How you going, Show Tim? Good to see you. And, Alan, we appreciate the well wishes today, man. Go back this way. Oh, dude, I went the wrong way again. Oh, no, we got this. I'm only gonna just make it if I do. Almost out of here. Hey, so Blake says, which system did you like on the whole, Sega Genesis or Super Nintendo? That's a hard question to answer because there was really good games on both. I mean, I spent more time playing Sega Genesis, to be honest, but to also be fair, that was the system I had the most access to. I think we just made it. Look how much health I have. We just made it. There it goes. This is 2 levels on, I could not get that thing. Fucking hell. 2 levels on hard difficulty, no deaths. That ended up being a very good challenge, guys, because that was quite close. So, with that being said, we're going to go back to the Wheel of Wonder. And what game do you hope I land on today, Moe? Karate Kid. Be 2 levels, 1 life. Alright, there you go. I have to be a Daniel-san some bitch today. You need balance, Daniel-san. Balance. Babe, do you think I have balance? Oh, gosh. There you go. I have a funny feeling that Moe's working against me. She's pretending here to be supportive, but I think she wants to make me this ice cream today. Yeah, yes, I like dessert, not with fish chili sauce. Yeah, it's alright. It's very different. I'll be sure to let you know. One more. So all we have to do in this is beat 2 levels with 1 life. So this one and then the first Okinawa level. And that's it. We actually did a full playthrough of this the other day. So I've had a little bit of practice and preparation on this one. And yeah, you know, we say there's a show on Australian TV, or used to be on Australian TV, and called The Mole. And what that basically means is there's like teams all trying to compete and work together to win a whole bunch of money. Eventually people get eliminated, but there's one person in there that's a traitor and is deliberately trying to sabotage everyone in secret. And so there used to be a show called The Mole. So what happens is, let's just say there was a team of 16, and so 15 regular members and one mole trying to sabotage everyone. At the end of each episode, they would have to vote and guess who the mole is. And the person who was least closest to guessing who the mole is would get eliminated, until the last person standing finally figures out who the mole is trying to sabotage everyone. So yes. That was a good show. I'm surprised it's not on TV anymore. Frederick says she's not impressed with your karate yawning in the background. Oh, I'm sorry. I think she is actually impressed with my karate yawning, because my girl knows how hard I work. Thank you very much. Although I don't mean to be unprofessional, guys, but when you're doing this 7 days a week, you can't hide it all the time. Human beings get tired. It's just normal. We did try and get some extra sleep last night, didn't we, babe? How are you feeling? You feeling fresh today? You're not? Yeah, I'm not feeling fresh today either. I do feel better after the coffee, though. That's alright, babe. After the show, take it easy. How you going, Ronnie Craig? Good to see you. How you going, stand out from the herd, Mike? Good to see you. And Master Rogue Assassin's like, you have to find your balance, son. Yes, I do. Here it is. I think we're going to get through this quite easily. I may end up changing this challenge to 3 levels and 1 credit. Because that challenge is actually pretty easy. But be that as it may, we passed it, babe. So now we are on 2 and 0, and we're looking pretty good. Yes. Go me. Let's spin wheel again. Let's see what we got. We currently have 39 minutes left on the clock. It's been a very quick episode of Beat or Eat It today. Very quick episode. We already did Bomber Raid, so we have to spin again. Easy, no problem. What do we got now? Sunset Riders. Ooh, this is a bit of a tricky challenge. Sunset Riders, beat 2 levels, no deaths. Although, with that being said, I am getting better at Sunset Riders, so bring it. This is a Cowboys game, babe. Do you like cowboy movies? Probably don't watch a whole lot being from Thailand, do ya? Have you ever seen a cowboy movie? Yeah. I used to love Young Guns 1 and 2 growing up. But yeah, you might not have seen it. Maybe one if you watched. They have action. Yes. Yeehaw! Do that one, babe. Go yeehaw!
Yeehaw!
And say this one. You'll come back now, you heard? Do that.
You'll come back now, huh?
Oh my gosh. That's awesome. Alright, yes. Yeah, Tombstone's a good movie. I think that one would be a bit slow for Moe, though. Tombstone's a great movie, but also a very slow burn movie. Oh, gosh. How you going, Eric? Good to see you. Eating some pork. I'm always down to put some pork on my fork. Thank you, Kevin. Yeah, I picked a good one. Of course she's sweet. I'm not going to pick a lousy one, am I? How you going, Nigel? Good to see you, brother. Thank you so much for coming in. I saw you sent me a message today when I was half asleep. I've completely forgot. I think something to do with Sonic or something. I couldn't even open up my eyes yet when I got your message. I apologize, Nigel. I'll check it properly a little bit later on. Yeah, Nigel sent me a message first thing this morning. I couldn't even see the freaking screen. Yeah, one of those days. Yes. And how good is Blazing Saddles? I think most people still find Blazing Saddles funny, just as long as they don't come from California.
It's time to pay.
Oh, that was close. You see, I'm jumping over bullets now, babe. Bury me with my money. He says, bury me with my money when we kill him. We have to see it. Ready? Bury me with my money.
Ready? Bury me with my money.
Bury me with my money. Oh man, there you go. Nigel's given me some homework. He did some digging into a new Sonic game. Hopefully it's not too hard to play. I'm not generally very good with Sonic. Don't forget, usually most Sonic games I play with save states, which is why I can get through them. I don't know how I'm going to go in a Sonic game without save states. Is it a PC application or is it a ROM hack? What's my favorite black box game for NES? With the exception of Super Mario Brothers, it's either Kung Fu or Excite Bike. But I also really liked the original Golf back in the day too. But no, it'd be Kung Fu or Excite Bike if we're not counting Mario Brothers. It's gonna be a close one this week, Faye. As I said, you know what I think's happened? We had a massive day for donations yesterday. So today is a little bit on the quiet side. With that being said, quite often Josh completely vanishes a whole stream and only makes himself known right at the last minute. But I just have a funny feeling that after all the shooties this week, Josh is going to give me a week off. So I don't know. I just have a funny feeling there's going to be no sabotage this week. Well, it might not be a bad thing. Do you remember how much I had to eat last week? Jesus. Yeah. This is the last week that we're putting Moe's Mystery Dish on the line. Next week, we are doing Australia's Hottest Hot Dog, aren't we, babe? We're doing Australia's Hottest Hot Dog next week. Because what we're going to do is we're going to buy a generic hot dog. And then we're going to get the Da-Bomb sauce that Jeff Tweedledee Tweedledum has sent to us. And we're gonna smother the hot dog in the bomb. Yeah, so Australia's Hottest Hot Dog. Yes. Zach wants me to do a sour bean. Alright, Zach, I can do a sour bean. Thank you very much. Zach Brust. With a big, all right, we need a, not one of these ones. Yeah. Well, Zach technically almost paid for two, so give me two. He actually paid double what he had to. There you go. Oh, God. Thank you, Zach. She got a lot of the white pixie dust on that one. Oh, God. We actually passed that. I don't know. Usually, I lose this challenge because I like stress. But I was just so calm today. Boom. Yeah. Thank you so much, Zach. Zach is a good sport, kind of. There we go. We're on 3-0, everybody. If Josh swaps today, I'm kind of screwed. Let's spin the wheel again. All right, let's see what we got this time. And Ninja Gaiden. We already did that one, so we're going to spin again. Well, no, we can do that. F-Zero, win two races, Night League on hard. All right, there we go. We're going to win two races on Night League on hard. You have a good point, Damo, and you can actually get a chili dog from this hot dog place, so we could probably get the chili dog and then put the chili sauce on it as well. So, no, that's what we'll do, bro. That's a perfectly valid point, and that is what we will do. Thank you very much, Damo. Freaking having his little freaking 2 cents there over on the YouTube. Telling me what hot stuff I should put in my body. It'll be all the shooies in my bloodstream keeping me relaxed, Nigel thinks. There we go. So we're going to do the Night League. I got to reset. I've got to do it on hard difficulty. Hang on. Sorry, guys. I'm having an issue getting this started. Hang on. You don't see where the clock went. Clock these nuts. How's that sound? All right. There we go. So let me just save here. Night... expert. Oh, dude, there's standard and expert. Jeez. I think I'm gonna get absolutely smoked. The only thing going for me is, all right, well, let's go. We have to do this on difficult. We have to do this on difficult, everybody. Danny says, just trying to help. Way to make one coin only feel bad. Way to make one coin only feel bad. Jeez. Look at me, you asshole, for getting angry at people trying to help, babe. Yeah, we're only... Are you looking for... tell everyone, babe, by the way, how much you're enjoying the wrestling at the moment. What would you give it out of 10? Honestly, how much do you like it? 7 or 8, yeah. What do you think of the story? You're sick of it? You get, yeah, like Cody Rhodes, you're just constantly talking about the story. Do you think that gets annoying? Or, no, you like, okay, she still likes Cody Rhodes. I thought you were annoyed by him. I told everyone you were starting to get annoyed by him, so now I'm a liar. That's all right. What about, No, she doesn't like The Rock. Okay. She like him in movies. She doesn't like him in WWE. NXT seems boring. I can only watch NXT in small doses. Not because it's not good, but just because I only have a certain amount of time. Yeah, she loved R-Truth when he accidentally won and R-Truth didn't even realize he won. She found that quite funny. Yeah, R-Truth is a bit of a national treasure. go. We're in second place. Who's going to win two races here? There you go, we're in first. So we use two turbos in this next map. And we might be able to win if we're lucky, babe. Might be able to win. This is on the hardest difficulty. Just two Night League wins we need, guys, on the hardest difficulty. As you can see, I've had to work for it. As long as we don't hit the other cars, that also makes things a little bit difficult as well. As a Doom movie, I thought the Doom movie itself was kind of shitty, but like some of the cinematography to make it feel like the game was pretty clever, I thought. But no, I mean, I did think the movie itself was pretty... Oh no, I lost on the final straight. This game's a carny. I just lost, babe. On the Yeah, I have to be number one. Yeah, because another car, like, backmarker gotten in the way. You know when those cars that are, like, losing get in the way? Yeah, those assholes. What do we got now? Snow Brothers beat 10 levels, 1 credit. We're going back to the arcade now this time, everyone. I think Bailey's gonna beat EO. Who do you think's gonna win, Bailey or EO? You know that crazy Japanese faction? You know, with those ladies with the face paint? Who do you think's gonna win? Do you think it's gonna be the lady from there, or do you think it's gonna be Bailey? You know that, but you know that girl Bailey that got betrayed, and she's like, "Yo, I was just trying to be your friend, and you heard me." She's fighting EO with the belt. You know the Japanese girl. Yes. That's okay, we'll watch SmackDown this week and then you can tell us. Don't forget, Moe's still learning wrestling, guys. We all... Ah, fuck you! I just died already. That's alright, I've got a whole credit here, but that's put me on the back foot a little bit. Oh my gosh. Jeez, I died... That's like the equivalent of me dying on the first mushroom in Super Mario Bros. Oh gosh. You're not familiar with Snow Brothers? Well, that's most unfortunate, Banarco. How you going, Rec? Good to see you. And so Blake says, does Moe like wrestling so far? I tell you what, if she doesn't, she's being a hell of a good sport because she watches it with me twice a week. She's bracing herself for WrestleMania. She knows we're going to have a big weekend WrestleMania, don't you, babe? Yes. I'm in WrestleMania weekend, I'm probably actually going to stream in the afternoon instead of the evening. And then, I'll probably stream in the afternoon instead of the evening. And so we can watch WrestleMania uninterrupted. So I'll have to get up very early. You don't, I have to. You don't have to. But yeah, stream for a couple hours and then watch WrestleMania. Yes. Because there's no point streaming on the actual event, I just realized, because everyone's watching the event. So, I'll stream before the event. Yeah. Damn it, we just lost again. Oh my gosh, dude, And Chris wants me to add two wins. I'm gonna freaking need them, brother. I can't believe I've died three times already. This is Damo's jam. He must be very disappointed in me. Guys, Chris has just dropped an epic 4,000 stars, and, but it's too late for you, man, because you're already awesome.
It's too late for you. You're already dead.
Or dead.
The hell are you talking about?
It's too late for you, Chris. You're already awesome.
What the fuck? No, help me, please.
This is the North Star. I got that one. It's based on a very famous Japanese anime from the 80s. It's called Fist of the North Star. It may have been in Thailand, actually, but I don't know. But it may have been. Thank you so much, Chris. I can't thank you enough, you legend. Seth Rollins or Drew McIntyre? I actually think the Scottish guy is going to win. What do you think? You know, the guy that's like, oh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Who do you think's going to win, him or the Scottish guy?
Oh, yeah.
I think the Scottish guy is going to win because I don't think Seth Rollins has taken it seriously enough. So I think Drew McIntyre going to win. Yeah. I think Seth has taken Drew way too lightly, honestly. Yeah, I'm picking Drew McIntyre for that one. Oh. Do you dance like Seth Rollins, babe? Come on the camera, you have to. You have to. Oh. Damn it, I just lost Snow Brothers, everyone. Sorry, Damo, I kind of lost my focus on that one today. Yeah, I'm down for Drew. I'm down for an epic Drew Hill run as champion. I think it's his time, to be honest, for the second biggest belt in the company. I can't remember. Oh, I don't know what I said. It's too late for you, Chris. You're already awesome. That's what I said. We got Rad Racer. We're going to beat two races, no crashes. Yeah, I said it's too late for you. Because you didn't even need to add two wins because you're already awesome, you see. It was a compliment. I'm trying to tell you how awesome you are, Chris, and you're missing the point. You just knocked my arm, babe. Don't make me put you on the list. I was trying to pick a game and you knocked my arm. Yes. Well, say sorry to the list. Oh, gosh. Yeah, you should have seen her reaction when Seth Rollins was dancing yesterday. She loved it. Oh, it's okay. We're just going to win two races here. No crashes, everybody. I really hope Josh doesn't sabotage us this week, Chris. Because you've really gotten us off on the right foot today. We're probably on the list, yeah. Don't forget, I'm going to be careful with that one because she's put me on my own list before. Hope you're doing great, by the way, Kevin Flint, over on YouTube. Nice to see you over there for a change. I know he's always lurking, but don't forget there's 1 week over the last 2 months where Josh shocked the world and let me have a week off. I personally don't mind if it's this week. Oh, there you go, you brought the Takis in here, hey? Yeah, they're hot, but they're not that hot. I think you could handle them, babe. Your mouth's gonna be full, though. Yeah, man, it's incredible. That's why I just went straight on to tier 4. Because unless I get banned by Facebook, Chris, there was no chance that we were not gonna hit tier 3. So don't forget, guys, tier 4 is the freaking big one. Tier 4 is a console giveaway, a 24-hour stream, a 12-hour stream, a t-shirt giveaway, 5 custom stickers for the top 5 star senders, and also the private game session with 3 members of the community as well. So, obviously there are bigger, but I would say tier 4 is the first of the really big ones. And yeah, I think for the first time in a while, it looks like we're going to be doing a console giveaway at the end of the month, so that's pretty freaking exciting. That's pretty exciting. Yeah, they are a little bit, aren't they? Kind of lemony or limey, kind of almost. It's like a lime sort of flavor. How you going, Eric Wright? It's good to see you. Ain't nothing gonna break my stride. Ain't gonna... Oh, I forgot the words. Oh. No, I'm all good, babe. I had enough, I think. How you going, Wildy Run? Thank you for coming in on Kick 2. Yeah, man. I think the cap is at 800, which, I mean, you're only going to hit that kind of total, like, once a year. But 800 is multiple console giveaway. So who knows? I mean, the way things are going this month, you never freaking know, hey. But I'd be willing to guess that we'll be giving away at least one console this month. And as we bloody should after all the support you've given me, so... Don't forget the prizes get drawn to the top 50 star senders. So the community prize, like the excursion and everything, and the perks, like the 24-hour marathons and 12-hour marathons, that's for everyone for your support. But the major prizes, that like the shirts and the games and the consoles, they're for the top 50 star senders. Just as sort of like a heads up, if usually you go into the pool if you send around about between 500 and 1500 stars a month, depending on the month. That usually gets you in the top 50, just a heads up. So anyway, at the end of the day, I just appreciate that you guys like what we do so much. Thank you for everything. Ricky, hard question, are you Team Yeet or Team... No, I'm Team Yeet. Yeah, that's another match at WrestleMania, the two twins fighting each other. Yes. That'll be a good match. Yeah. Yeah, we like Jey Uso because he dances. We like the Yeet dance. And what about the commentator that dances a lot? It's so funny, Pat McAfee. You know, the guy in the announcer's desk that always jumps on the table and... Oh my gosh. I think Michael Cole's underrated as well. If you occasionally see the camera on the announce desk, Michael Cole gets pretty animated on the microphone too. Like, Michael Cole uses a lot of energy on the announce desk. That is a classic. You got the girls doing it in the 90s, and then there was a reggaeton version in the 80s by, what's his name? How you going, Chris? The original one was like a reggaeton jam. Reggae jam. How you going, Sandra? Sandra Day, how you been keeping? Thank you for coming in. Welcome to the stream. We've got Nikki LaGrosso in here. Thank you for coming in, Nick. Oh, I have an itchy nose. I always play racing games and get an itchy nose. No, see, that's the thing, bro. When things are going well, you need to work even harder, Chris. The last thing, I mean, I understand your reasoning on that, but, nah, man, I don't want to get complacent. I want to keep pushing and keep building the empire, you know? So when things are going well, that's when you work even freaking harder. I've been guilty of being complacent before. I'll never make that mistake again. How you going, Brian? Good to see you. Thank you so much for coming in. At the end of 2021, I remember things were going well, so I coasted a little bit and I lost a very lucrative contract. That was an expensive lesson I'll never make again. Tell you about that behind the scenes, actually, babe. Yeah. Jeez, that was an expensive lesson. Won't make it again. There we go. We just won. That was all right. There we go. So that was 6 wins and 2 losses. And now we're going to go back to the Wheel of Wonder. Yes, and we have to thank Chris. He's like my savior today, babe. Yes, thank you very much, Chris Dog. 14 minutes to go, everyone. Win, lose, or draw, you're getting a bonus game today. Oh, we got a longer challenge. We got Castlevania, and we have to beat 3 levels with no sub-weapon. So this is going to take us pretty close to the finish line today. Yeah. Gosh, could you imagine? I mean, it's a little bit of an underwhelming episode of Beat or Eat It, but it's just, sometimes things just work out, huh? How you going, Brian Seymour? Thank you for being in here. Yeah, it is. But they're hot, but not the hottest things you've had. No, yeah. 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 So, I mean, honestly, it probably wouldn't make a great punishment, would it? Unless I ate the whole bag, but then that's a lot of calories. Yeah. Eating the whole bag would burn. Yeah. And so Banaka says Moe really loves you. Yes, but I really love her too. We're a great team. Well, what's it, babe? Teamwork makes a dream work? Yes, we make this dream work. What do I think about Banks? So how much money do you think they gave to Sasha Banks? Jeez. Yeah, I feel like Tony Khan's a little bit of a spoilt brat with too much money to play with, to be honest. Tony Khan's billionaire dad basically gives him as much money as he wants, and he's like, okay, son, go run a wrestling company. And the guy's basically like a billionaire, like a 34-year-old with like $1 billion given to him by his dad. He's running a wrestling company. So he's a little bit controversial, but it's okay. I guess considering he gets all his dad's money, I'm surprised he's not more of a spoiled brat, so I guess he's okay. Honestly, if $1 billion dropped out of the sky at his age, if I was the same age, I'd probably be worse. Not now. Now I think I'd have the maturity to handle it. Not that I'd never ever want that much money, but... Man, so Colin says Sasha Banks is Mercedes Monet. Yes, I'm aware of this. And so Chris says, has anyone here talked to Big Rome? I haven't spoken to Big Rome in a while. Not for any other reason that we've lost touch. But I hope he's doing well. Yeah, I mean, it depends. I mean, if you were running a company with that much money, you'd be doing it for the love of it. You wouldn't be doing it for the money. So, I mean, you've got guys like Elon Musk, who has more money than freaking anybody. And I think Elon genuinely, I mean, look. Obviously, I'm not going to be completely naive. He's a powerful man, and he wants to hold on to that power, but... I do think he genuinely wants to change the world, and I think that's why he does what he does as well. So, I mean, any business or any company or any passion project you did with that amount of money would be because it's good for the soul. You wouldn't be doing it for the money at that point. Yeah. You okay, babe? She's burning the hell out of her mouth. She's eating the Blue Heat Takis, guys. Banako says, I've noticed that your rants have calmed down a lot and your patience has increased since Moe's come in your life. It has, but don't mistake me. There's still a lot of things in the world that piss me off. I just pick my battles. I don't want that kind of power ever, Chris. I do want freedom. But freedom is power, isn't it? I do want freedom. Everyone wants freedom. Do I want power? Not really. Although it's like the ring in Lord of the Rings, isn't it? My precious. Once people get it, they're corrupted. Honestly, let's just say I was free, I'd probably stream once a day, and we'd just be traveling around, like, new places all the time, probably, babe. That'd probably be the extent of what we do, huh? Hi, welcome to the One Coin Only Emoe Show. Today we are streaming from Ho Chi Minh City. Hi, everybody. Today we're in Seoul, Korea. You know, like, we'd just be, like, game streaming from a new city all the time. So that'd probably be it, really, hey. Yes. maybe from our nice little stream from our nice house in Udon Thani. Bring Champ on the show. Look, you know what, the thing is, I can tell you right now, Banarko, it's like whenever, the mistake most humans make is when they gain a lot of money, they increase their lifestyle tenfold. It's just, people underestimate how much it costs to maintain their lifestyle, and then, yeah. You can have a lot of money and still be poor. Like, I'll give you an example. These NBA players and NFL players, no one teaches them money literacy, so they're still poor in the head. Because, you know, people that are good with money get assets, and then people that are not good with money, they'll spend it all on liabilities. And, yeah, I mean, these NBA players and NFL stars, they're just getting liabilities. Then all of a sudden, boom. How you going, Stevie Fields? Thank you so much for coming in here. I hope you're having a wonderful day. Yeah, we can shoey time. We haven't had to do a shoey today, which is probably good news. It probably means I can actually go to the gym today, which is good. Okay, I understand, Chris. Hey, man, sometimes Facebook's just a bit too personal. I get it, Chrissy Johnson. Oh, you just cleaned your lips. Your tongue's blue. Yeah. The blue tongue lizard. You're the Australian blue tongue lizard now, babe. Yes. Thank you, Shane. I'll keep pushing, hey. Thank you everyone for coming in. I've had a really good time today. I feel like this has been a little bit of an underwhelming episode of Beat or Eat It this week. But hey, look, sometimes it can't always be close. Sometimes you can have a blowout. It just is the nature of the beast. We'll see how we go next week. How many more minutes have we got left on the clock? Can we have a time count, please? How many more minutes have we got left on the clock? Minutes, really? It's quick. We're gonna do a bonus game after this. I don't know what we're gonna play yet, but we'll do a bonus game after this. Five minutes left. Exciting, everybody. Exciting. Coming up on 5 minutes. Gosh. Probably have time for one more game after this. Don't forget our goal for this challenge. Is 3 levels, no deaths, and no sub-weapons. We haven't seen Josh say boo the whole entire stream. I have a funny feeling he's having a rare day off this week. Don't forget, Josh has dropped a bazillion stars already this week. I think he's having a day off. And I for one, am not offended by that. Okay, babe. Oh, okay. Thank you. You think I just jinxed it? I don't know. Josh is, don't forget, Josh is not a robot, he's a man. He can only do so much. He said he was looking forward to tonight. Ah, he was bluffing. He was bluffing. Oh gosh. Jeremy says, what's on the menu? Well, Moe's making a mystery, well, it's not really a mystery dessert dish. I'm having ice cream, but she's making a fermented and fish and chili sauce to go on it. And so instead of having chocolate sauce on my ice cream, she's making a fermented fish and chili sauce. So it's a mystery item this week. There it is. All right, my friends, we just won another challenge. That's probably, what, 7-2 now? Yeah, 7-2. All that, so we got time for one more. Let's see what we have here, everybody. All right, Joshy King. There you go. We already did Aladdin, so we have to spin again, everybody. Joshy King. I don't see no fucking Joshy King. What do we got? We got Life Force. Beat one level on one credit. We can do that. Joshy King. See, look at that. I'm poking the bear today. Oh my gosh. Kevin's like, don't say his name. Nah. I'm not scared. You can't live your life in fear, everybody. You can't live your life in fear. Okay, you can't live your life in fear. Alright, we got this. Yes. No fear, everybody. No fear. How are we looking on the clock? How many minutes left, everybody? How are we looking on the sumbish clock? Oh, there we go. Oh, dude, I just died! I totally screwed up there, but it's okay. We'll get there. I'll see you when we get there. If we ever get there. Taking that Coolio song back. I'll see you when we get there. Right, we got this. There you go, there's like three cures for constipation here with these little horns. Ah, fuck off, really? Damn it. 20 seconds left, really? Yeah, I think we're good. I think we're good today, guys. I think we're good. Damn it. There you go. The bell just went off. We're good this week, everyone. We're good this week. I told you. I freaking told you. I just had a funny feeling this week was a little bit different. But, guys, happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to me. Oh my gosh. Everyone, thank you so much for coming in. I'm going to be a good sport. And yeah, I'm going to do a bonus game for you all. So let me see what bonus game we can play today. Josh, oh, there you go. Josh says, I don't want you to lose this week, but you can do a shoey. Now that, okay. Okay, babe. I need a shoey, please. Oh my gosh, that is not what I was expecting. First of all, we're going to summon Shenron before we do the shooey. Thank you, Josh. So what we'll do is we'll do the shooey, And then I'm going to do a bonus game for everybody. Thank you, Josh. Thank you. Hey, man, you're a good sport. Josh wanted me to win this week. Yeah, Josh, he's being a nice man today. Now, we kudos to you, bro. We appreciate it so much. All right, we're going to do this shoey. That's all right. Well, I'll be able to go to gym still because after this shoey, I'll do a bonus game and then I'll be fine. All right, cool. So here it is. This is the Canadian Club. This is Canadian Club Whiskey and Dry. We're going to pour this in. Here we go. Here's to you. Here's to me. Hope we never disagree. If we do, fuck you. Here's to me, here's to you. Thank you. Oh, I'm about to drop that from all the way to the liquid. Here we go. Oh, here we go, Joshy. Okay. Josh, thank you very much for everything. Yes, next week we're doing the world's the Australia's hottest hot dog with your sauce, Jeff. It's so cold. Oh my god. Josh wants me to do another shoey. Babe! We need another shoey! Oh my god. Oh my gosh, Chris wants a third shoey! You guys have been in a private group, haven't you? Jeez. I know what you guys are up to. You've been in a private group planning this. My gosh, Chris and Josh.
Three.
Wow. Two. Wow! Well, that just changed the plans for the day, didn't it, babe? Alright, well, here's shoey number two. Damn, man, I hope Facebook's not gonna get me in trouble for binge drinking. I didn't think I'd have to do this many in a row. Far out. Alright, once again, guys, here's to you, here's to me. Hope we never disagree. If we do, fuck you. Here's to me, here's to you. Alright, there it is. Oh. Man, Josh and Chris, thank you very much. I'm going to have to play a beat-em-up today now as a bonus game. Or yeah, wow. Oh my gosh. God. Okay. I didn't think I was going to be this degenerate on stream, but here we are. Far out. All right, here's the third, shall we? Oh my God. Here we go. Steven says, I came here at the best time. He kind of did today. Bowie's going to have to run the stream while I have my bathroom break in about 5 minutes. Steven says, I wasn't expecting to join and see you drink out of shoe. Yeah, this is a brave new world, everyone. I was hoping that my content creation would do something to benefit the world or make it a better place. Yeah, today it's not. Oh my gosh. I'm going to have to play a beat-em-up for the bonus game today. Alright, here we go. Thank you so much to Josh and Chris for all the shoeys. Now that that's done... Oh, God. Alright. Metamorphic Force, yes. Please, please do not do what I'm doing at home, kids. Oh, gosh. Yes, the shoe was clean. We do need to give it another disinfect after this stream. We need to put some wet wipes over it. Maybe I'll have to put it through the wash. But we're going to do Metamorphic Force today, everybody.
awaken, my brave warrior.
Well, hey, if I can't go to gym today, the very least I can do is go for a bit of a walk. There goes my gym plans. Yeah, all these shooies are now starting to affect my health, everybody. Gosh. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, the shoe does add a little extra flavor. So Chris says we didn't even plan for that. Wow. I thought Josh, and maybe Jeffrey were conspiring in some group to maybe make that happen. Swap gym for gin, yeah, exactly. The game volume is crazy loud. Oh, it is? Okay, I can fix that. There you go. Let me know how the game volume is now, motherfuckers. Let me know if that's a bit better. Is that better? No, oh my... Babe! I need another shoey! Yeah, now Moe's starting to get a little bit concerned, everybody. Fuck. Oh. Boy. So we only got another two left. Oh, geez. And, oh, we got a star party on top of it. Really? Josh, thanks again, man. I mean, at this point, I don't know if... Oh, gosh. Thank you. I don't even know what to say at this point. You say it best when you say nothing at all. Anyway. Yeah, thank you, Joshy. Oh, gosh. Yeah, Joshy had different plans. Instead of having me eat ice cream with fish sauce, he wants me to booze up. We want to get to 6,000. Yeah, don't forget, if we get to 600,000, we're giving away one console. If we get higher than that, we're giving away more consoles. But I'll put up the update very soon. All right. Nah, don't worry, David. I know my limits. I know my limits, bro. All right, this is going out to Josh once again. Thank you. Here's to you. Here's to me. Hope we never disagree. If we do, fuck you. Here's to me. Here's to you. Thank you very much. No, I'm okay. Everything, I know my limits. I'm a 43-year-old man. Well, ask Moe if I know my limits. She might share a story or two, but anyway. How you going, Bill? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Oh, gosh. I tell you what, I was hoping to be a role model, and I've turned into a degenerate, hedonistic sumbish. I am the reason that Western society is going to collapse, everybody. Oh my gosh. No, they're not alcohol free, I can promise you that. They're 1.4 standard drinks a can, I think. I think they're like, hang on, I'll tell you exactly how much they are a can. I'll tell you exactly how much they are a can. Hang on 1 second. Yeah, I don't know if you can see there, but they're 1.4 standard drinks a can. So there you go. Chris says, add 7 sour beans to the celebration. Babe! Poor Moe. I need your help. No, not a chewy, I need something else. Thank you, Chris. I just need you to give me 7 sour beans because... Oh no, I can do it, I guess. No, I can do it. I can eat 7 sour beans. Chris wants me to eat sour beans. Oh my god. Oh, those 7, those 4, shillings just went straight to my head, babe. Yeah. Tell everyone, babe, am I a good drunk or a bad drunk? Yes. I've never been bad when I've been drinking, have I, babe? Yeah, she says, I'm not bad, just crazy. Yeah, what? Oh. You know what one of my best memories were? When we had that party with your friends at Moon Bar when we were dancing on the table and shit. Oh yes, my god!
I still have that clip.
We need to share that. That was such a great memory. Oh god. There's no shower. Yeah, we were dancing on the bar. Oh, I was dancing on the bar.
You dancing on the corner.
Yeah, oh god, that's sour. Thank you, Chris. No, Josh, God bless, thank you. Josh, thank you to you and other members of the community like Chris and Jeff and Tom and everybody else. I'm almost 100% certain this month we're going to give away a video game console, some shirts, and maybe even some other prizes. So, everyone's been so generous, and it's going to be wonderful to give back. So, you know, someone, and you can pick a console of your choosing, just a standard console, so just a standard Switch or an Xbox or a PlayStation 5. Yeah. Who knows? Whatever, you know. It'd be awesome. Hey, Josh, you're amazing. It's all good, man. I'm really not worried about, considering that it's only the 19th in America and we have 12 more business days this month. I really don't mind if I work the next 2 weeks for free because we've hit our start goal. So it's like, just come in and have a good time, man. Just enjoy for the next couple weeks, Josh. There's absolutely no pressure on you, homie, man. Like, even if we didn't make a single other star for the rest of the month, this is still probably gonna be like in the top 3 months of like the last 12 months. So, man, I'm blessed. I'm very, very blessed. And I'm very drunk as well. Yeah, man, it's great. So we're just going to come on for the next 2 weeks and we're going to have some fun, hey? And whatever happens, happens. So, if anything, this beautiful one over here, Moe, she always reminds me and grounds me to, and makes me remember to always be grateful for what I have. So, yes. She's a good influence for my life, everybody. I'm just gonna get very drunk now. Oh, yeah, maybe. I knew after I did all those shooies I was gonna have to play a beat 'em up because I wouldn't be able to do anything else. This is crazy. This is like me trying to stream on New Year's. Hey Blake, thank you very much for the... Hey bro. Thank you very much for the 500 stars, Blake. That is super generous of you, bro. We're gonna do this one for ya. Let's get some hype in here. I can't believe we lost, in all seriousness though, I can't believe we lost, Carl Weathers at such a young age. Like, Carl Weathers wasn't that old. Does anyone know what, does anyone know the cause of death for Carl Weathers? Not to be morbid or anything, I just, you know, I mean, I used to watch, what was it, Carl Weathers on the, was it Boba Fett? He looked like he was in pretty good shape for an old dog. So I don't know what happened with him. But, I mean, it was such a shame, you know. Oh, we got this. Yeah, I don't know what happened. It was a bit of a surprise to me, because I didn't think out of anyone that he would be the one to go, but... Oh, it was a heart attack, man. Yeah, bro, that's rough, hey. Life is pretty fragile. Heart disease. Shit, hey. He just seemed like a healthier, older guy, you know what I mean? I just didn't see that happening. Yeah, man. Yeah, make sure you middle-aged dogs get your heart health checked, hey? Hey, go on, Edmund. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Oh, Nigel's gonna get his heart checked tomorrow. Yeah, I should probably go to the doctor and get a health check soon, hey? Did I get it done here or in Thailand? Yeah, no, I don't mind paying. You think, oh, fair enough. Just like, maybe see Australia doctor. I don't know, I mean, if you're in the city, I think the Bangkok hospitals, or Bangkok or Phuket hospital is probably pretty good. Yeah. Oh, he's a farang. We're gonna charge him 10 times the money. Oh, Western man, he have money. How much? $1 million. Yeah. Oh, really? Why, what, just...
A tam.
Huh?
Oh, a
tam. Just for a check. Fuck that. Where was, what city was that in? They're private. If private's really expensive. I'm not gonna lie, private is better, but only rich people can afford that. Oh my gosh, I've got the hiccups now. Walkers, thank you very much. This is for you. Oh my god. I've got the hiccups. We got Moe here with a tiger bomb trying to keep me alert, everybody. This is crazy. Yeah, so... Have a good one, the Walkers. We've got a big shout out to Mick, Pip, and Timothy. Thank you very much. This is a game called Metamorphic Force, this one. Metamorphic Force, this game is, everybody. It's an arcade game. It's a hidden gem. This game is incredible. But yeah, Moe's, next week, we're not doing the Moe surprise. We might bring the Moe surprise back one day. But next week... We're doing Australia's Hottest Hot Dog. So, as long as it arrives in time, because Jeffrey has sent us the bomb sauce. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to the hot dog place, and we're gonna order a chili dog. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna absolutely smother it in the bomb sauce. And that's gonna be the challenge, basically Australia's spiciest hot dog. So that's what we're gonna do next week. Yes. And so Chris says, Australia's Hottest Hot Dog sounds like a Chippendales show. Well, yeah, it's called the Chippendales in America. but in Australia it's called Manpower Australia. Now, baby, I used to DJ for the Manpower Australia and Men Down Under shows. I used to DJ for the men that would do the stripping. And if I was a husband of one of those wives that went to these Manpower shows or Men Down Under shows, I'd be very, very out, very worried. Because this is where these crazy middle-aged women do the fake orgasm competition. So every time you have a male stripper show, the women in the West have to do like a fake orgasm show. And the woman who does the best fake orgasm wins a prize. And that should make men very worried about actually how good they are in bed. But I digress. Yeah, how these women perform at these Manpower shows doing the fake orgasm competition is very convincing. It's like, holy fucking shit. And then you've got the male stripper, oh man. And like the male strippers dancing on these like housewives that are bored, and they're like sitting there and they're really enjoying this naked man dancing on them. It's just like, yeah, shit. Like, guys, I'd be really, really, really worried if your woman went to one of these things. I'm just saying. Oh my god. Peyron, you're actually hitting a fine line here, Peyron. I would watch your mouth, bro. Peyron, you are really, really crossing a line. And I'm not angry at you, Peyron, but you are crossing a line. Yes. Crossing a line, Peyron. Crossing a line. You guys, and I'm not going to be angry, but you guys need to know what that line is. And yeah, you're way over it. Yes. Are you proud of me, babe? I didn't get angry. Yeah, actually, we should put Peyron on the list for that, shouldn't we? That's all right. Yeah, I think Peyron needs to go on the list. And that's going to be a really big fine, too. Yeah, thank you for reminding me. Everyone just narked on you, Peyron. Peyron on the list for being incredibly inappropriate. Peyron on the cunny list. Peyron for being a disrespectful asshole. Oh, there you go, asshole. There you go. See, Peyron, you're on the list for being a completely disrespectful asshole. I'm gonna charge him a very big fine. You know how much I'm charging Peyron? 5,000. There you go. That's your cunny list, bro. 5,000. Cause that was pretty disrespectful, bro. You're like 5,000. 5,000. Seriously, that's a big sin right there, bro. Dude, he's never... Yeah, there you go. Everyone's like, nice. Yeah, he'd never get my off list. You're going to have to do a lot of Uber Eats jobs or a lot of DoorDash to pay that fine, bro. Jesus. That's a big fine. Yes, we can organise a payment plan for Peyron. Yeah, Nigel's like, 5,000 is reasonable, considering the line Peyron crossed and it has its own zip code. That was gone pretty far. Fuck, man. Yes. You never know. Someone might pay for your transgression, but I think you're going to have to do it yourself. Oh, God. No, look, you know what, babe? As I said, everyone in here means well, but there's just a couple people in here. And look, I know this is not politically correct. I don't care. Some people are just socially retarded. And I know, like, Peyron didn't mean any harm, but he's socially retarded. So, he's on the list for 5,000. Oh, that's amazing. Man, I love that Tiger Balm, babe. You know what, babe? I smell that and I feel like I'm in Thailand. It's great. Yes. We have to go to Thailand in May. I have to see your family. My goal is I'm gonna go to Thailand probably two times a year. So probably in May and then in December. So and then the rest of the time you're here. The rest of the time Moe live here. I only have to go to Thailand two times a year and then Moe get her visa the rest of the time. Hopefully. Hopefully the Australian government good to you. Oh gosh. I wish I could bench 350 without working out. Guys, I only do I only do like four. I'm not that big a guy. So I do four reps of 120. I do four sets of 12 reps of 120. I'm not a big guy. I'm not that strong. You know, I could probably do maybe one push of maybe, I don't know, 250 or something. But I do four reps of 12 on about 120. So I'm you know, I'm not that big. I reckon I could do one of 250. I should see what my record is. I need to just set a really high weight and see what I can do. Yeah. Maxing out is overrated. Yeah, I think so too, to be honest, Steve. That doesn't mean shit, to be honest. What matters is how many full sets you can do at a certain weight. I agree with you, Steve. I do. I think you're gonna help me at the gym though, because Moe cooks me a lot of eggs. And eggs are real. Yeah, you. Like, I think we had like four or five eggs yesterday, didn't we? And so, with all the eggs that you give me, like, you're gonna help me for gym. When I actually go to gym. I can't go to gym today now. Alright. You guys are affecting my health in a negative way. But the good news is, Josh says he has no more stars this week. So I can actually finally go to gym. I'm probably gonna have to go to gym for 2.5 hours on Friday, babe. Good night, David Craig. Thank you for coming in. When it comes to gym, I'm not trying to show off. I just like to keep healthy, you know? You know, a lot of people come in here and they say, I can do this and I can do that, which is good. And I respect you, and I commend you, but I only do gym for health. I'm not trying to show off or be a bodybuilder or anything. Chris says working out is like sex, more reps is better. I was about to say something that I won't. Well, let me put it this way. I reckon Chris and his lovely lady have the same kind of relationship as what we have, and I'll just put it that way. That's all I'll say. Damn, I'm getting donkey punched here all day. Guys, this is the worst game. I'm dying every 2 seconds, babe! Oh my gosh, I'm bad at this. We are very happy. We never fight, we never argue. As I said, we've only probably had like, what? like, if we're gonna be transparent, we've probably only had, what, maybe a couple disagreements, and we talked it out, and it was just done. Yeah. We're easy. Josh says, I actually tore a bicep tendon, you won't see me heavy lift ever again. I couldn't even imagine a bicep tear. I couldn't think of anything worse, hey. Ugh. Steve says you have to cut yourself flat, slack, you had four shoeys. How are you talking? Like, it's not that I've had that much to drink, but I had so much to drink so quickly. I'm grateful to Facebook for not banning me. I am actually grateful for Facebook for not banning me today. Hey Ron, when are you going to pay your 5,000 cunny tax? How are we going to do this? Are we going to do this in 1,000 installments, or what's the plan? Payron, I'm a loan shark, but I mean, I have a heart. I'm happy to do a payment plan. I'm willing to do five installments of 1,000. Five installments of 1,000, Payron, next week. I get paid next Friday, I got you. Okay. You have until next Friday. And if you don't do it next Friday, I'm going to break your thumbs. It's going to be like Rocky Balboa when he goes on the docks. You have until next Friday. It's okay. Yes. And if you don't pay it, I'll send Big Bubba to come and we'll discuss your situation. Oh my gosh. Yeah, in my younger years, I was actually friends with a couple loan sharks. Yes. And I used to hang out with one quite regularly. And how he explained it was, I would be sent out to discuss people's situations. That's how he explained it. Yes. Hey, I mean, in this DJ life, I mean, I do meet a couple shady people. Do you think one shoey can absolve this debt? I think Payron will probably get me a shoey next week. Oh, there you go. Josh says, I still got to do physical therapy 2 times a week, even a year post-op. Yeah, I don't know too much about biceps, but if we're talking about the WWE, CM Punk has done like a tricep injury 2 times in like 18 months. And I don't know, and there must be something about arms that has a longer healing process. It seems to be the thing. Oh my gosh, babe. Yeah, adventure. Gotten very quiet all this. Too many pull-ups and push-ups. And Payron says the doctors told me I have to go to physical therapy again. They might have to do surgery again. Oh, what did they have to do surgery on? I think where I feel the most vulnerable myself personally is like in my shoulders or the pectoral. So my biggest concerns when I do weight is when I do shoulder exercises or chest exercises. I don't feel too bad on the arms. Like, I don't ever feel like I'm gonna tear a muscle on the arms. But sometimes I worry about doing either chest exercises or, not even so much chest. I think my biggest concern is probably my shoulders. My shoulders or my knees. So I feel like I have to protect my shoulders or my knees the most. Anything else I do is okay. Hey, Steve says you're a handsome man. I'm just saying. What do you think, babe? Thank you, brother. You flatter me way too much. Richard says, what time is it in the land down under? 20 to 1? Too early. Chris says, I ended up having spinal fusion on my neck. That's scary, bro. Oh. I struggled probably the most with shoulder exercises. The workout that concerns me the most is shoulders. Definitely. I can hardly talk right now, babe. Holy shit. I think if someone sends me another shoey, it's gonna send me over the edge. Standout from the herd says, I've done my fair share of lifting this past week at my job. Yeah, I know some of you guys have pretty intensive labor jobs. Yeah. Well, as I said, when it comes to me and gym, my focus is more on health than heavy lifting. I would like to get a little bit bigger, but not at the expense of pulling a muscle. So, you know, I'm happy to do slower gains and slower progress than trying to push too hard and then putting myself in the hospital, you know. So I'm trying to, you know, I don't mind if it takes me double as long to get extra muscle, if it means I not have to have surgery. No, it's okay, babe. Oh, be careful. Don't go too fast. Someone might give me another shoey, babe. I think it was a smart decision playing a beat-em-up with how many shoeys I've had to do today. But yeah, when it comes to shoulder exercises, I only do about, I can't remember how many kilos it is now. Or in a matter of a few minutes. Yeah, man, I'm tipsy as. Payron says, I have to get new tires at the end of the month. Yeah, you're gonna have to save vehicle, bro. I don't want you crashing or having an accident, brother. Yeah, wow, that's a lot of bags there, Mikey. How's everything going, Brandon Dubler? Thank you very much for coming in. We're gonna take on this lady boy in a minute. The next boss is a lady boy. We have a lady boy boss in a minute. Oh, Jaquan. One, here comes the one coin only on the stream. Here he comes, everybody gonna beam. One coin only, doing all these awesome games, and anyone that doesn't like it is really lames. Everybody in the club getting tipsy. Okay, I should not do improv when I'm drunk. I did the worst improv of Jaquan right now. I thought the Triple X song by Jaquan was even better, to be honest. I don't know if you guys remember Triple X by Jaquan, but I thought that song bumped even more. But Tipsy is the Jaquan famous song, but I thought Triple X was better beats myself. Do you remember Triple X? Do you remember Triple X, Payron? Yeah, that's the other Jaquan song, but it wasn't as big as Tipsy. Nah. Have a look. Go on YouTube and check out Jaquan, Triple X. Just XXX. I thought the beats on that one was better. Yes. I don't know, does anyone in here remember Triple X? What are we gonna call it hood hop, are we? I mean, hey. Hip hop was so much better in the noughties, bro. Hip hop was so much better in the noughties. I feel like once we had all this mumble rap come out in the early last decade, it was all over for me. Some of it was alright. Actually, I'm not gonna lie, when mumble rap first came out, you know, like Tiger and all that, when mumble rap first came out, it was good. But then it just got way overdone. Damn, look at this lady boy sitting on me. What are you laughing at, bish? I'm a little bit jealous. This chick's got broader shoulders than me, everybody. This chick has broader shoulders than me. Oh gosh. One more time, if you're enjoying the stream, we just ask you to like the stream, share the stream. Thank you for the thumbs up, whether you're on Facebook or YouTube today. I didn't mind the 2 Chainz style for a little bit, but that got a little bit old as well. But I didn't mind the 2 Chainz style for a little bit. Are we up to 530,000? Jesus, man. We're 12 days to go. Bro, fuck at this point, Chris. I'll just work for free for 2 weeks. I'm easy. I'll work for free for 2 weeks. As I said, I'm not worried about the stars as much as I am about the turnout. I just want people to come in here and have a good time. You have a good one too, Banarco. Thank you so much for coming in. Yeah, you can, Chris. You don't have to do shit, bro. Relax. Just enjoy the content, my homie. Maybe getting us to 600,000 would be nice to give out a console and a few other prizes, but apart from that, I'm good. Man, I tell you what, I'm a little bit nervous about doing another 24-hour marathon, but I think we can do it. I don't know, Chris, I'm feeling so unprofessional right now, being tipsy and everything. Fucking hell. I wasn't expecting to have to do 4 shooies in one stream. I did not see that happening today. It's up to you guys. I can either buy a console in Australia and send it to you in America, or I can buy you one over the internet from your own. It depends. I make it as convenient and helpful as possible. So what happens is, if you do win a console, I'll consult with you behind the scenes and I'll give it to you in the most convenient way possible. So it's easy. But you know, a standard edition Switch, PlayStation or Xbox is what's on offer. So I'll make it as convenient for everyone as possible. Oh no, that's okay, Patrick, I got you. Yeah, we got whatever Wednesday this morning and then tomorrow evening. And don't forget, it's not too late to grab a green shield. You get many perks for the green shield, including the VIP group, all the custom stickers, multiplayer priority and streams. And the biggest perk is the Whatever Wednesday request. We do Whatever Wednesday once a week, where you guys can come in and pick a retro gaming for us to play of your choosing. I do have to apologize to everyone in the VIP group. You guys can all talk amongst one another. There's been some bugs on my end where I haven't been able to post too much. The only reason I haven't been more involved in the VIP streams or in the VIP group is because of a Facebook glitch. But it is still a great place for you guys to all talk with one another and make some friendships and basically have like private relationships and all that. Look at me trying to sell the VIP group one now. Jesus. Anyway, guys, just get the subscription to get a fucking Whatever Wednesday request, okay? We're doing Whatever Wednesday tomorrow. In the evening and in the morning. Yes, I certainly hope that there's no duds tomorrow. Yeah, there's a bit of a glitch right now where it's most days I can't post in the VIP group. It's frustrating. So I don't want people to think I'm being lazy. There's actually a bug at the moment. But I'll sort it out. We take them live on the stream, Eric. So what we do, brother, and thank you very much for having a sub. We take them periodically on the stream. So, as I said, I'll be on in the morning stream and in the evening stream. And we usually take 5 to 6 requests at a time. And then what we'll do is we'll play them. And then we'll take another 5 and 6 requests. Usually we get between about 35 to 30 on a week. Which generally seems to be enough. Because not every sub comes in every week. And so getting at least 30 requests on a week usually seems to be enough. You have a good one too, Stevie Fields. Thank you very, very much, brother. Man, I feel like this game has gone longer than what it normally does. But I feel like my concept of time has slowed down on this bad boy today. My concept of time has slowed down.
It's great you made it here. That's it for your lives.
Oh, look at this, guys. It's the final boss. And he's got like a bazillion forms, so brace yourself. Oh my gosh. You basically messed with my health today, guys. I can't go to gym today now. Oh, you think it's Barry Gibb? You think it's one of the Bee Gees? So I'll play, I'll wait, and I'll pray it's not too late. And I'll play, I'll wait, and I don't wanna be alone. Anyway, move it on. Does look a little bit like Barry Gibb. So I'll play. Anyway. Don't forget, the Bee Gees are from Queensland. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. The Bee Gees are from my city. The fact that they got big after leaving Australia is irrelevant. The Bee Gees are from my city. Yeah, the F1 is in Australia this week. Guys, we just got raided on Twitch by Nefarious. Big shout out to the whole Nefarious community. Thank you so much for coming in today. I hope you guys are great. How you going, Nefarious Intent? You guys could have trusted One Coin Only's community with anyone, and yet you came in here. So thank you very, very much today. I appreciate you. So I'll play, I'll wait. Yeah, they may have been born in Manchester, but they spent the first freaking 15 years of their life in fucking Australia, so fuck you. Okay. So I'll play, I'll wait, and I'll pray it's not too late. Anyway. I will say this, Seth. This game is way smoother to play than the X-Men arcade game. Way smoother. This game is way smoother. How's everything been going, Cody? I hope you're amazing, by the way, bro. Thank you for coming in. Yes. Are we gonna start singing How Deep Is Your Love? No, I don't think the Konami beat-em-ups are too long. This one's about 40 minutes, which I think is perfect. I will agree with you that Capcom beat-em-ups sometimes go for way too long. Because sometimes Capcom beat-em-ups go for an hour plus. And, you know, a game like Cadillacs and Dinosaurs, even though it's absolutely awesome, I do think it outstays its welcome after a certain period of time. But, you know, I think a 40-minute beat-em-up like this is totally acceptable. But, I'm not going to criticize Konami. But, yeah, I definitely think Capcom beat-em-ups are too long. Is this called Metamorphic Force Nick at Night? What a great freaking screen name, Nick at Night. What's your favorite Nick at Night TV show? Is it Mary Tyler Moore? Is it Bob Newhart? Is it The Saint? Is it I Love Lucy? Is it The Honeymooners? What is your favorite Nick at Night show? I am Magneto, you are nothing. I am Magneto, welcome to die. X-Men, welcome to die. Anyway. Yes. Oh, your favorite was Mr. Ed. I don't think we had Mr. Ed on the Nick at Night in Australia. I mean, we had Mr. Ed in Australia, but I don't think it was on Nickelodeon. Terrence, I Love Lucy was a classic, hey? How good was I Love Lucy? That was one of my favorites to watch as well. I personally preferred I Love Lucy over the Honeymooners, myself. Yeah, I Love Lucy was great. My grandmother got me onto that. Da 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 da. I remember the music. You did a run through of Quickie World. I don't even know that game, actually. What console is that one on, my friend? Aliens vs. Predator is a good one. If you do really solid on that game, it's about 50 to 55 minutes. I think the perfect length for a beat-em-up is about 40 minutes. I think once you're getting over 40 minutes, with a few exceptions, it's probably a little bit too long. Oh yeah, Get Smart's a classic as well. Yeah, Bewitched, I Dream a Genie, all good stuff back in the day. For sure. I guess I'm going to have to sober up and get started on my offline content right now. This stream has been absolutely nuts. I want to thank everyone so much for coming in. I'm glad that you enjoyed the stream today. And a big special shout out to Josh and to Chris and to everyone else for their generous donations. This month has been an absolute blessing. Thank you for all that you do, guys. This is really, really nuts this month. Yeah, I'm going to go offline, sober up a little bit, and then I'm going to start some of this offline content, going to make some more videos. I'll probably make one of those 3-minute videos today. Go on fb.com/starscody, and I think that'll give you the cheapest stars that you can possibly get. Yeah, I ended up winning Beta Eat It today, bro. Ended up winning Beta Eat It. But, yeah, we'll leave it there, guys. Thank you so, so much for coming in. A big thank you to Nefarious Intent for the very generous raid. God bless, bro.